Hello.
Dick?
Hello, Mr. President.
How are you?
Well, I'm just fine. I haven't had any sleep, but you know how that is.
I sure do, and I give you my congratulations and my sympathy.
Boy, I tell you, isn't that the truth?
Dick, I want to keep in close touch with you along the line we did in our last talk, and I want to try to play this thing as much in the national interest as is humanly possible and as fair as possible. And I have just one purpose, and that is the best interest of the country, and I believe that your conduct has been very responsible. There are some developments that have not changed the picture, but that I think you would do well to know about. I don't want to influence any of your decisions. I wouldn't change anything that I have seen that you've done. If I were in the same position, I would have pretty much followed the course of action, which I understand. I haven't read everything, but I'm away from the picture. But
you meant my statement on Vietnam?
Yes.
We was pretty responsible. I
so I
we're holding the line. Actually.
I had this thought. Vance is here. He is going to be going back to Paris. I don't know what your plans or Agnew's are. Humphrey is coming here tomorrow. He's campaigning in Texas. McCarthy's in Houston. And Humphrey is in Corpus Christi. He's coming by on his way to Corpus. And I'm going to bring him up to date with what has happened. And there have been some things happened, additional outlets since we talked. I thought I ought to say to you at the same time that if either or both of you were interested, that I would consider, I had not planned to do this with him, but I would consider bringing Vance down here if you went from Miami to California any time in the next 2 or 3 days before he has to go back. And I would bring Vance and Rusk here, and I would meet with you or whoever you wanted us to and bring you up to date on what's happened.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it is not the thing that you are that you raised the question about. It goes in the opposite direction, but it's something that I think that would be well for you to know, and I would say that there's great pressures that you ought to know about, which, in the light of my own views, I'm not going to succumb to.
Yeah, right.
But I think that in an hour or an hour and a half, that it would be good to, if I were in your place, I would want Eisenhower or you or somebody in the summer place to discuss it with me. And my position's going to be, I'm going to exercise the responsibility up until somebody says, so help me God. But until that moment happens, I'm going to try to keep in touch with both leaders and see that they have it 50-50.